On its edges, Kirkuk seems like a city walling itself off. Rich in oil and in religious minorities, it's a prime target for ISIS militants who seek to loot and impose their radical beliefs. And as ISIS advances to the south of Kurdistan, they're closing right in. In fact, with the naked eye, from these Kurdish trenches, shaky in the heat, you can see something remarkable. An ISIS checkpoint waving locals through. And a line of ISIS flags that, along this road that parallels the Kurdish lines, spells out a new reality.
Those black flags at that checkpoint in the distance, that is the border of what these extremists have declared now as their Islamic caliphate.
Curious how ordinary life and traffic seems here, meters from what Washington calls threat number one. This front is frozen, neither side moving for weeks, even though they exchange fire daily. These men are called Peshmerga, Kurdish for those who face death. But here, they face militants who actually court death, dream of it in battle. There is an anxiety here, where ISIS has become part of the landscape, even over a school roof, about a full-on attack. Where these lines would have to hold to protect Kirkuk's Christians, Shia, Turkmen, minorities ISIS would murder.
Well, it's on this expansive front line around a vital city that you have to ask yourself, what's the limit for the White House's involvement here? These Peshmerga want airstrikes now to push ISIS back, to stop them breathing down their neck day by day. But does America really have the appetite for that?
The commander describes how near last month ISIS militants came. They came at us from the border, he says, and from this village as well, really hard. It took us 3 days and two nights to hold them back. These lines will hold, they say, but they have little faith in the Iraqi army to help. And out here, the West's declarations of support sound like whispers, while ISIS are close enough to shout at. Nick-Paton-Walsh, CNN, Kirkuk.